To be having a respectable preacher, manners. Hallelujah.
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 In actual fact, he's an international preacher. I look at him as an international preacher. Because his ministry has been accepted worldwide. Amen.
Amen.
If he preaches here, and he allows it to go even on YouTube, it's the message is heard by several Christians all over the world. Even those who are in Ukraine.
Hallelujah.
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 And so I really feel we are privileged.
Amen.
Amen. Well, the Lord knows how to do His things. He knows how to arrange His programs. Nothing is out of kilter, brother, sister. It's all for a purpose. And where two or three are gathered in His name, He says, I am right there in their midst. There's a purpose why He's right here with us. There's a purpose why He has brought this minister among us. There's a purpose why He has anointed him today with a special message to the bride. Not just to us, but to the bride. And somehow, the arrangement is so perfect until Brother Moses here, right in his place, right in his office, to do the job well for the sake of the bride. I'm saying for the sake of the what?
Bride.
So it's a serious issue.
Amen.
You never know when you are going to hear the last message, brothers. Maybe this one is the last one, and it's the one which will take us into glory land. Who knows?
Amen.
That's why I'm saying, let's take it as a serious issue. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
All right. So, I want to appreciate Pastor Ngwenya, Dr. Ngwenya, Dr. Mobile Ngwenya. He's a brother who speaks a mountain of you, like us, you know, elders. He speaks a mountain of us. You don't deserve it. He says, I was groomed by these people. Now I think he's now grooming us. Amen. Now, Brother Jonah had to correct me today. He said, Pastor, it's not Sister Chala, my wife, who actually inspired you to listening to Pastor Ngwenya's messages. What actually happened is I'm the one who was listening to his messages. And then I introduced these messages to his mother, to her mother. And then the mother also introduced to he also introduced to his wife, and they were caught in the same web like that, you know, listening to his messages. And then we saw it on Chala's status, that she was posting the link, you know. Then my wife started trying to listen to them. She was enjoying them. It was so good for her. And I also joined, you know. And you know, we were just inspired by his messages. Like, It became a home issue. You know, we just wanted to hear that voice in our home, following his messages. So I thought it was Sister Achala. Or if you want to say Mla. It's up to you. But Brother Jonah corrected me today. And so I said, Brother Jonah, so you converted us all like that. to be you know, listeners of Pastor Ngwenya's sermons. Then he said, yes, you are my converts. I would like to thank the Lord for Brother Jonah. He's the one who actually influenced us all to listen to Pastor Nguyen. And he said, that's why we invited Pastor Nguyen to come from far with him. Amen. It's not so much of his wife, as for us, the wife is the closest. You know, because I saw it on her status. Amen. Thank you very much, Sister Chala. And thank you very much, Brother Jonah, for being of good influence to us. We want to say to Pastor Ngwenya, we really enjoy you. Enjoy your messages. I think it's for the bride. Keep it up. We'll be praying for you. Amen. Hallelujah. There's no need of introducing him to you again. I did introduce Pastor Ngwenya to you yesterday. As he was a marriage officer, but I think you heard the way he was speaking that there's fire in him. Amen. And so I asked Brother Jonah to talk to him. I know we're busy with the wedding, we are not much to give our pastor here, but I think we can share somehow in the word of the Lord. Amen. For man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth from the mouth of the Lord. Amen. Whenever I listen to him, I just hear the word of the Lord. Amen. And we love that. Amen. He brought with him, is he still here? Right. Pastor
Mande Mujati. But there is young from this Kid Moyo.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you say the name again?
Kid Moyo.
Keith Moyo.
Yes.
Right. Pastor Keith Moyo. Amen. I think that's easier for us, isn't it? Moyo. Amen. All right, so happy to be with you. We want you to feel at home. Feel free. Serve the Lord with gladness in this tabernacle. You know, amber light is the color of God. Pastor Mandemo do and Zivanda the other side, okay? All right. But Pastor Moyo, Brother Moyo is here with us. Amen. All right. Thank you for that. Thank you. I was thinking it was that other brother. All right. In any way, we are so happy to be with our friends. We want them to feel at home. Give us whatever the Lord has placed upon their hearts.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And without wasting much time, remember, if Brother Moses is doing something, your amen is going very far. Hallelujah.
Amen.
ukatsunurira amen yacho kuchaende yakatsunurirwa asi ukaende yakazara ukabvire kuendesa yakazara na glory wakazara hallelujah yakazara zvichabatsira somebody now say amen. All right, as I invite our precious brother, there is a song we enjoy very much. I don't know how to sing it very well, so just forgive me if I make mistakes. Forgive me, but we enjoy it very much. Amen. Hallelujah. Mama yangu tenda, 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 mama yangu tenda, tenda.
Certainly happy to be here and I feel at home. And I know the Lord has something special for us.
Hallelujah.
I'm inspired to stand where our elders have worked. And being part of the work they have worked, there's generational impartation. As much as they've imparted a lot on us to make us who we are, we have a responsibility to impart on these young brothers also, and they will also impart on our children.
So
the same relationship that started with Paul, if it was a red stick, we don't want to finish with the yellow one. We want the same power of the gospel. The same message of the hour, going all the way through. A person used to visit us in Highlands. I was still at school there, and I never dreamt of being a preacher. I didn't know preaching was entering me and becoming me. The sermons were entering me and becoming me. And ministry was entering me and becoming me. I don't know what's becoming what there, but when I was preached to, I became the same one.
Yeah.
Like that man who says the worst revival, I am the worst revival. This man did a great work. The message was being introduced in our nation at that time, and there were no hit list and computer work. It was God inspiring his servants, and we got it in his spirit. So we are in this responsibility to also preach it in his spirit. So thank you, Pastor, for the kind words. Actually, he should be reversed. Yeah, he doesn't know what he did to us. You know, when we're seated there and absorbing. But those who will be absorbing today, you won't absorb forever. One day you must release to another person in the street. At school, at scripture, you know, whatever, you are infiltrated.
Yeah.
Now, we'll open our Bibles. As we are about to close, right? I'm saying closing, we open our Bibles. So we're opening the closing chapter of Isaiah 66. Isaiah is a Bible, 66 books in the Bible. It talks about the old creation, up to the millennium, the whole restoration. Actually, when you get to Isaiah, you know, the Bible is 39
books, Old Testament, and then
27.
So when you get to Isaiah 39, he changes in chapter 40 and says, the voice is good and it's not just in the New Testament.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So from 40 is now in New Testament. Although you will be mixing here and there, of course. But my scripture is in verse 6 there. It says, a voice of noise from the city, a voice from the temple, a voice of the Lord that renders recompense of his enemies. Before she traveled, she brought forth, and before her pains came, she was delivered of a man child. Who has heard such things? Who has seen such things? Shall the earth be made to bring forth in one day? And deliver them from their infirmities. So God is sending his word today. We are sounding the trumpet of jubilee. Oh my, you must be free. It's a day of freedom. It's a day of deliverance. No one must be bound from now on. If you want to be sick, it's your choice. If you want to be poor, it's your choice. But God is more than able. This is a season of change. Even our weather is changing. Our mind has changed. Someone's name has changed also in waiting. Your situation can change. If your situation has a starting date, it has an ending date. That's why our elders say, if your situation doesn't end today, actually it will be a miracle that it didn't happen. It's going to happen. If you believe today, just focus on your situation. Your mountain will move by the power of God. We have a practical God who deals with practical situations. Until I believe doctors must refer to church. Because the great physician is here. The great emancipator. The great Jehovah Jireh. The great healer. The great surgeon. He is here to touch you today. The end time message. We will meet the end time conditions. So if there is a situation in your life, it will have a head on collision with the message. You is more than ready to give you the power to receive. It is important for us to meet that supernatural being and have that transforming experience as well. That's what our youths need. That's what our couples need. That's what all of us need. When you have that experience, the Bible says, no matter how fundamental a church is, unless the supernatural is made known unto the church,
amen,
the church will never thrive.
Amen.
Until the supernatural is made known,
I'm
going to pick my elder, Pastor Mabuku, there. God bless you today.
Amen.
The God of the Bible is alive.
Yes.
It's not enough to just read the Bible without the God of the Bible. It's not enough to read the spoken word without the God of the spoken word.
Amen.
What you feel when you are reading the spoken word is what must be tangible in your life.
Amen.
That's what we are inviting now.
Amen.
Our God is a God of the now.
Amen.
He's not a God of after the service.
No.
As I'm preaching now, someone is being delivered. As I'm preaching now, someone will be saved. Someone will be forgiven. Someone's life will be changed for him. Your appetite, your habits, your desires. The whole question is not ours. What I know is that God will do it. Blessed is she that believeth. For there shall be a performance. Don't even ask what if. Our God can never fail. I'm very sure that today here, someone's life is being transformed. God can change things overnight. The reign of Rahab the harlot. Becoming the Rahab the
the ancestor of Christ. Under the token, under the scarlet crest. We read about Jephthah, who was the son of the harlot, becoming a captain in Israel.
Yes.
When God comes to change the course of your life, mercy will rewrite your life.
Amen.
That transforming power is packed in the sermons. God works by the sermons. When he looks at your situation, he meets a preacher in the study room about your situation. He picks scriptures and gives the preacher because of situations that are there in your life. We read about Mary Magdalene, who was full of devils, becoming the first one to see the resurrection. We read about Paul the persecutor, becoming Paul the apostle. We read about Legion the demoniac, becoming Legion the delivered. We read about Tribons, becoming a mighty army. When God spoke to the Tribons and said, "Oh, you Tribons," there was a shaking in the valley. And I say, "Oh, you try marriages, try patience, try finance, try youth. Hear the word of the Lord." Let there be a shaking and a revival in your life. We read about many people before second. Law in Lodiba invited in one day to sit at the table. You are invited to a higher life. Come up higher. You have been too long in that mountain. God hates stagnation. God hates a stagnant life. When God is with you, there must be movement. You must keep advancing. Pray higher and higher. When you reach a higher plane, there's another higher plane to come. Our God moves every time. We read about Elijah moving from a juniper tree of discouragement to the mountain of the Lord. If you are under a juniper tree, if you are passing through a dry patch, things can change for you to change. But one thing you must know is that when God is saying things must change, He is talking about you.
Amen.
You don't push it to another person.
Amen.
Sarah actually believed that God can do great things. Sarah thought it was through Hagar. When God meant Sarah, and when she laughed,
Amen.
God said, even unbelief doesn't hinder God.
Amen.
And God says, next year at this time, even if you laugh, even if you laughed, next day at this time, you'll be carrying the results of this.
Yeah.
Months of preparation of being serious about it. If you are serious at that time, God would have said 9 months from now. Because Mary was serious about it. And it became 9 months from that moment. But Sarah, because she laughed a bit, she was given 3 months to prepare to be serious about it. Because when you mean business with God, God means business with you. So for Sarah, it became 12 months. Because it was next year at this time. But nothing will stop it coming. Even if they will say, "We'll never be married," you shall be married. If they say, "You will never receive the Holy Ghost," today you will receive the Holy Ghost. Our God is able. In one day, to change everything. We see Joseph moving from prison to the throne in one day. We see Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego moving from the fire to promotion in one day. We see Daniel moving from the lion's den to promotion in one day. There is nothing impossible with God. Overnight, when Hezekiah was praying, when he woke up in the morning, 185,000 Syrians dead. And the angel was passing by, doing what Hezekiah could not do. And I believe the angel still visits the neighborhood. The angel knows you by name. He knows your address. He knows the number of your head. He knows what you are passing through. He knows how much you can bear. He knows your unspoken desire.
man, you know yourself. In just one day, when Dagon was in the presence of the Lord, he fell down and he was crushed to pieces. It was in one day, just overnight. Pharaoh woke up. He found the firstborn dead. Just overnight, all demons and family priests that were holding you, all evil desires, all evil habits, all bad dreams, all your chains and bondages, all your yokes shall be broken because of the anointing of God. Just overnight, brother, the disciples visited that fig tree that was spoken to the day before. Then they found that it has responded. It has dried up just overnight. The Christ says, have faith in God. What things soever you desire, if you say, if you pray, believe it, you shall have them. Those want the answers tomorrow. Look for us tomorrow or another day. But those want the answer today. Just be ready today. Our God cannot fail. Our God is more than able to answer. What is diabetes before God? What is HIV before God? There's nothing that can stand before our prayers. God is able right now. Those Paul and Silas were praising God. They forgot about their chains. They forget about their bondages. They started praising God. In a rhythm that chain could not follow. In a rhythm that chains could not follow. Then the chains fell down. In one day, God had done it for them. Paul had suffered for 14 days. Shipwreck.
Amen.
Some of you have marriage, like some of you have financial. There was a shipwreck, there was no star or moon, no hope. There can be a hopeless situation, but there must not be a faithless situation. Faith must operate even when there is no hope. In that day when there was no hope to be saved, the angel stood in the midst of that ship.
Yes.
May you stand in the midst of your life.
Hallelujah.
And Paul was delivered there. Then the sister was in hospital. In the message angel of the Lord. Whatever situation you are in,
amen.
Enter it with the word of God.
Amen.
Enter it with the pillar of fire. She entered the hospital with the pillar of fire.
Hallelujah.
And then the pillar of fire came out of the picture.
Amen.
Because it started meaning, it started visiting her. And she was discharged by the pillar of fire.
Amen.
The pillar of fire is yet to discharge you. That glorious ember light is in the ember light tabernacle. Answer every situation. So don't limit God to what you have passed through and what you have seen. God can do what you have never had. He can do the impossible. Then the sister was looking for a goita just overnight. As if she wanted it, but she wanted to be sure it's God. John Rhino was blind for 20 years. That day came. And what he was testifying about, he kept speaking about. He kept believing it. He kept saying it. But it happened at the least expected moment. When he was attending to his beard, God was attending to his eyes. Because faith was peace. Even in your driving, let your faith be peace. Your faith, even in your dreams. Solomon in his dreams was visited. And God says, ask what you want. I believe God can change your health today. Can change your even your breakthroughs that you are fighting. Your breakthrough is coming. We are not negotiating it. We are enforcing it. In the name of the Lord. Even the longest cases. There's a woman who has been having a situation of a life issue for 12 years. But one day, swallowed the 12th. The 12th of sickness was sorted by one day. What you look for 10 years, God can answer it in one day.
Hallelujah.
George Carter was babysitting. It was almost 9 years.
Glory to God.
But she kept as a bleating lamb. Calling someone. And the call was heard in the realms of the spirit. And God sent a prophet there. In, as things were happening, she jumped from the bed, not fired the bathroom, but to the keyboard state. See that great physician. Now is here. Let me tell you, he is here now. He is here now. And any situation that was bothering you is expired. In the name of the Lord Jesus. It was 66 years. 66, brother. But that one day, answered the cry of 66 years. And the Lord teaches us that the reason why you have a desire is because there's a power somewhere that says to answer that desire, or otherwise, you would never have that desire if nothing was coming your way.
Amen.
And the promise is hanging over you now. If you believe for anything, you can have it now. It doesn't matter. I was just listening to a testimony viral on social media. Pastor Chandler's church there.
Yes.
A sister was barren for 17 years.
Yes.
And the testimony is now viral.
Yes.
Don't allow your problem to be viral.
Yes.
But your testimony will become a walking stick of another person.
Yes.
It will help another person.
Yes.
Because a testimony gives birth to another testimony.
Yes.
God specializes in things not impossible.
Amen.
There is someone who has been in the pool for 38 years.
Yeah.
38 years with infirmity. Thinking that the answer will come through the water.
Yeah.
But the answer came from behind and said, hey, you are looking for me. I will answer. He looked at Christ. Christ was 33 years old. This problem was 38 years old.
Come on.
But the answer was actually older than the problem. Because he is the ancient of days. Before you were born, before you were in that situation, your answer was written here.
Amen.
So your answer is older than your problem. God answers all matters that have stood for old long time.
Wow.
And God says, I suffered in many a way, in many ways. I cried for healing night and day.
Yes.
But faith was not forgotten. From the Father above. He heard a voice from heaven saying, your enemy is dead.
Amen.
That little squirrel that thought it would jump on him like previous times. It jumped and missed.
Mm-hmm.
There are some spirits that try to jump on you after church. They will jump and miss. That will be the end of that situation. I believe in a permanent solution.
Yeah.
I don't believe in healing the same matter over and over. I believe God can answer you permanently. We were preaching somewhere in Hope Fountain. And there was a sister with a lamp on the breast. Just by the platform. She touched and could not find it. It was screams all over. That is this kind of God that we worship.
Yeah.
I was phoned by a sister from South Africa. She had 20 years attacked by evil demons, what they call spiritual husbands, something like that. We may not have a message name for it. But we have a message answer for it.
Amen.
She was tired of that.
Yeah.
A child of God dreams visions of rapture. You don't dream attacks.
Yeah.
If you have attacks, we have to attack those attacks.
Yes.
We don't allow those things. Today I feel mangoromera like I have to fight. From a sheep court to be a king. God raises the poor from the dust of the earth.
Hallelujah.
If you talk about law,
long standing matters.
Israel
was not a nation for 2,000 years. And it became a nation in one day.
Hallelujah.
If you are dispossessed and the devil has stolen something, this is the day of restoration.
Amen.
Our God restores.
Amen.
Whatever the enemy stole from you, we are the law enforcing agent.
Hallelujah.
What was stolen from you? Now, if God paid the debt of your sins that you could not pay, He can fail to pay the debts that you are trying to pay. If He removes the weight of sin in your life, He can fail to remove the weight of sin. If you are tired of sin and you have never experienced new birth, and you have never experienced salvation,
Amen.
This is the day where God can save.
Amen.
You can move from a pestilence to a powerhouse.
Amen.
You can move from a dry patch to a fertile ground. Peter said, I toiled all night. But at thy word, when God has spoken, it doesn't matter what doctors have spoken. It doesn't matter what economists have spoken. Because never a man speak like this man.
Amen.
When God has spoken, all is changed.
Amen.
Your situation will change.
Amen.
Cornelius had prayed many times. And then in that one day, about the ninth hour,
yes,
at the time of prayer, God came down.
Yes.
He said, Cornelius, Cornelius.
Yes.
He knows you by name.
Yes.
Your prayers,
yes,
have come for a memorial.
Yes.
It was a memorial service.
Yes.
Of prayers.
Yes.
And God says, I remember.
Yes.
This month of May,
yes,
God remembered,
yes,
the prophet,
yes,
and visited him.
Yes.
In this month of May, on the 17th of the second month,
yes. Amen.
The Bible says God remembered Noah.
Mm-hmm.
And they ended there.
Hallelujah.
God will remember you.
Hallelujah.
God will break in silence. God remembers your prayers.
Hallelujah.
Some of the prayers you have forgotten.
Hallelujah.
God remembers them.
Hallelujah.
Some of your requests,
Hallelujah,
have not expired.
Hallelujah.
They are still valid.
Hallelujah.
Everything that the preachers have said about you in this book, it doesn't expire. It's still there for you. You see Job moving from the airship. From the airship to rejoicing again.
Amen.
You must move from discouragement,
Amen,
from poverty to riches,
Amen,
from oppression to liberty, from limitations to unlimited resources, to unfair resources. You see the prophet moving from a log cabin to around the world seven times. Peter moving from prison when the devil was intending after Easter to kill him, and the angel came and delivered him.
Yeah.
If you are in prison of lust, in prison of fornication, in prison of adultery, in prison of evil desires, in prison of family spirits, family trends are ruling in your life. No one waits in your family. No one is successful in your family. We are breaking those records by establishing records. No one waited in your family, shall be the first one. If no one drove a car in your family, shall be the first one. If no one became a preacher in your family, you shall be the first one. God changes things overnight. The prophet tells about those slaves. They were told that when you see the morning, know that you are free.
Yeah.
So the clever ones, they actually went on the mountain. They were under expectation. Because expectation is the breathing count of a miracle. So if you are expecting something, it's going to happen. So they stood on the mountain. The sun rise. They are rising. There is something to do with our liberty. Because in Malachi 4 says, the son of Rahab
righteousness shall rise with healing in its wings. Our God is delivering his people now. So when they were up in the mountain, they saw the sunlight first. They shouted to those who were down, saying, "We are free! We are free!" I started climbing here. So they can tell you then that we are free. We are free. There is a man here that can turn on the light. Our God knows how much you can bear. He's a meticulous God. He answers to your taste of what you want. He knows what you desire. And God is going to answer you. He gives you a permanent solution. But Robinson was tired of timber.
Hallelujah.
Matt Robinson was tired of temper. He says, "Today, Lord, if you don't give me the Holy Spirit, you'll find a pile of bones here." And God answered him. I was hearing a testimony in the evening yesterday. Another sister. The brother sister was hearing from Pastor Mandemo, because the person sent to me, but I was busy, I didn't find it. But Pastor Mandemo says, "No, this person asked me to tell you that they had a dream where they were driving. Then they reached the end of the road. They felt that things are ending there. Then they said, in that dream, a pastor, when you appeared with the weapons, I believe the weapons are not carnal. Mighty through God pulls out strong. He says, you started creating with those weapons a way." Then he says, "When I went to my job, I lost my job. But a higher contract opened, and I understood the truth. And I came to the end. Then God created a way." Our God is a way maker. When you come to the end of it, you may have a complacent onlooker. He sees, he says, I know. And because he knows how to do. And he knows when to do. Because he knows better than we know. And when he makes a step to your miracle, it's a greater miracle that time. There's a Mexican who came to the meetings with a dead baby. She was not going to be stopped by anything. Nothing can stop you if you have a desire. And she says, "I'm going back with my child." And God did it that day. I believe the third pool is in operation. While the pool was preaching, he says, "It's 2 o'clock now. This is the end of the second pool. This is the third pool. And now you are at liberty, but even as a Sunday school teaching child, to speak and go forward. To use the third pool. It's available. The word is like thee. Even in your mouth, the word of faith that you preach. That if you speak, your situation will hear your voice." There is a girl who wears braces and she was crippled. She had the way of going into the service. She bought the shoes for the miracle that will happen during the service. And when the miracle happened, she had a stepping point into what she prepared. And because she prophesied it, the prophet had to pick it. When you prophesy your miracle, the minister will pick your situation, because you already prophesied it. I was praying for Sister Precious when she was 47 years old. She says, "I'm going to be married." It's never too late. Our God can start where I am. When you are praying, you know, we are not usual people. We have no usual prayers or usual services, because we have an unusual God who does unusual things. Even when you are sitting in a usual place, especially unusual. Because our God is a God of the unusual. As we pray, something took over in prayer. And we say, in 2 weeks, someone is coming. When we say that, you know, sometimes we declare something in faith. Like Elijah saying, it shall not rain. Then the Bible catches him somewhere praying earnestly that it does not rain. He has said it, but he says, Lord, I've said something here. Make it so. Sometimes when we just speak like that, we go and pray earnestly that it becomes so. Sister, pray. What a shame.
Wow.
Say, since somebody is coming, you must wait in this shape.
Wow.
Now, she did what she could do.
Yeah.
What she could not do, there is a hand that was doing. I believe that hand is moving. Just say, pass me out of Jerusalem. While it's moving, we shout and touch the Lord.
Amen.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Brother Matanga is actually in Harare now.
You know, Brother Matanga, I are
it was a wedding day.
So,
yet a dream.
He
just dreamed that there was a wedding. The sister was standing at the platform, red, waiting for the brother. She had a gown. But Brother Matanga was wearing a wetsuit in that dream. Then the voice of God said, you are the groom. The sister has been standing for long. Brother says, I want to see who is this sister. Because he had no idea. Then he says, beyond the veil, I want to see your face. Before the sister precious. He says, oh, the Lord is precious. Then he's doing. So he has to put on a suit. That day when he had that dream, the sound of it, he wanted to see me. He knew that I'm now in South Africa. But when I was going to South Africa, I missed my flight. So he finds me and says, police, you are here. I want to see you. I have a dream. I said, who is the sister? It's his sister Precious.
Hallelujah!
I look at his friend. It's almost 2 weeks now.
Not only my victim, my
I said, God, when he. When
hallelujah!
Time, when the season matches the vision.
Amen.
And the inspiration.
Amen.
The season, the vision, the inspiration.
Yes.
And the anointing in your faith.
Hallelujah!
And the expectation.
Amen.
There will be an explosion.
Hallelujah!
There is a situation that the prophet talks about many times.
He
says there's a girl who had messed up her life. Until she thought no man would desire anything called her. She had been so filthy, so dirty, until the prophet says, was it Rosella or something? He says, you will make a good wife for a tired evangelist.
Wow.
No, it blows the minds of many people who are wanting many things. For a Christian. But when God
qualifies, amen.
The unqualified. Who can deny them? Gentiles were unqualified.
Amen.
Disqualified by birth and by natural birth.
Amen.
But God qualified us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
A jewel of grace.
Amen.
So if you are there and you thought God cannot bless such a person, let me tell you something. If you see the devil wanting to use you, it's because you are usable.
Yeah.
And God can use you.
Mm-hmm.
God can do something wonderful in your life.
Amen.
Don't let your past pull you down. God can do anything. I was reading about Brother Delbert in the spoken word.
Amen.
We just read Delbert. The prophet says, Delbert, he made blunders in life. And he had syphilis. And the doctors gave him all the shots that are good. It didn't work. It was the right medication for that right diagnosis. But it didn't work. Because there was sin. But when the prophet came, and the young boy repented, the prophet says, do you know God can heal you?
Yeah.
The young boy says, no, I'm not worthy.
All I want is eternal life. Let's talk about me meeting the Lord. And the prophet prayed for the young boy. Then after praying for the boy, he says, "Doctor, you can give him another shot now." The doctor says, "No, we have done that, it didn't work." But in one day, what the doctors were failing to do, they were doing it before Dr. Jesus. They consulted, okayed it.
Amen.
So, now after repentance, even medication worked.
Yes.
Do you know? You may be taking the right tablets.
Yeah.
But because of unconfessed sin, you are getting worse and worse.
Yes.
But if you just break that yoke of unconfessed sin, things start working in your life.
Yeah.
If you believe it,
yes.
You won't have another night with that situation.
Yeah.
You won't have another night in that condition. When Pharaoh was asked, when Pharaoh was asked, when do you want the frogs to go? He said, tomorrow. I think problems could cause chitzimira like
that.
He was problemed up by problems. He said, tomorrow, but he really wanted now. So he had another night with frogs as per his request.
Yeah.
But I believe today you won't have another night.
Yeah.
If you attack by demons in your night state, just what we have said now is enough.
Yeah.
People want a dramatic something.
Yeah,
Atishandi.
Yeah.
Change your situation. The man who is standing here now, I used to sell prisons.
Wow.
And jiggies in the streets. Miraculous insecticide for killing cockroaches in the streets of Bulawayo. When I was selling that insecticide, it's not far from our church. Where I'm preaching the gospel. It's not far from my center. Where I'm treating patients. Even if you have no starting point, this gospel is your starting point. Let me say this. In this tabernacle, God gives you building materials. God gives you John Sharitz. God does not work with your calculations. Your bill of quantities. God hears it in heaven. And that being in heaven has paid it covered. God moves elements to fulfill your desire. Painting troublous times. Overcoming in troublous times. In COVID times. We are prospering. In COVID times. All best and sisters are coming back. Do you believe in divine providence?
Yes.
Do you believe in divine guidance?
Yes.
Do you believe in divine healing?
Yes.
In divine visitation?
Yes.
In divine touch?
Yes.
In divine acceleration?
Yes.
In divine protection?
Yes.
In divine favor?
Yes.
In divine grace?
Yes.
In divine revelation?
Yes.
Because faith is a revelation.
Yes.
I need to finish because I feel the finishing is already.
Hallelujah.
You know, when we preach, we're trying to reach a climate that allows it to happen. When we reach that climate, what am I doing here? It's time for him to do what he sent us to do. Because we do this far, then he does the rest. Today, someone must be delivered. You are not a temple of diseases.
Yeah.
You are a temple of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Things happen during service.
Yeah.
When Peter had back, they were filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Then, is not a refuge camp for cowards. It's a rest haven for people to start. Veterans of faith. Someone is asking, where is the God of Elijah? You will see him in action.
Yes.
The same works that he did.
Amen.
He gave us a license to greater works and more works.
Yes.
When you are praying about something, be careful of nothing.
Yes.
But in all things, through prayer and supplication, make your request known unto God.
Yes.
Skip something. The Bible says, with thanksgiving. That is Philippians 4 verse 6.
Amen.
When Esther was praying for something, the king did not sleep that night. He came to sleep. When Daniel was praying the lion's den, the Bible says Darius did not sleep that night.
Yeah.
And the prophet says when Rebecca, the wife of Zacchaeus, was praying for
Zacchaeus
to be saved, Zacchaeus did not sleep that night.
Yeah.
The next day he says, I'm going to church. I don't believe you should come alone to church. Where is your husband? We want him here.
Hallelujah.
You came in here. Where is your family? Where are your children? We want them here. Sister and his children did not want, but she wanted more than they are not wanting. And because she wanted under the right atmosphere, under the super atmosphere.
Hallelujah.
God says, I give you children. Now, brothers,
sister,
the exploit she did, she didn't have much as we have now. She had heard a few testimonies of the prophet. So you have heard more now. It's not enough to leave it to Sister Yeti. And Oscar. And Roy Borders. Now is our time.
Amen.
Let's see the same God in
action.
The anthem was now only believe. It was not because Sigerelli's Africa. It was only believe. You know how it feels to see truckloads of your problems passing. And you see among those crashes there, mine is inside there. All the burdens are passing now. Among those tumors there, among those fibroids passing, among those goiters, among those pipes, among those things, mine is passing away. It's a rising of the sun. It's a new day for you. Things can change overnight. Let me encourage you as I'm closing. If a believer can change, that say the Lord. When Hezekiah was told, that say the Lord, you are going to die. He turned. When he turned, God also turned. He turned and prayed and said, Lord, I have valid reasons to live.
Yes,
do you have a valid reason to be alive?
Yes.
What is the valid reason?
Hallelujah.
It's because you are leading souls.
Yes.
Amen. That is a valid reason.
Amen.
So you tell the situation, I will never die. I will live to give praise. Maybe you think it's a one thing that changed, that's it, the Lord. Jonah came and says, that's it, the Lord.
Amen.
Nineveh shall be destroyed.
Yeah.
Those people repented.
Yes.
The cows were on sackcloth.
Yeah.
And they repented with their animals.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And God says, this is
something.
Yeah.
The only person who didn't want to change was John.
Jonah
says, I'm the one who said it. Because also God says, if my people walk up by my name, shall humble themselves, seek my face, I will hear from heaven.
Hallelujah.
In the message, make the valley full of dishes. Grace Weeper was told, that's it, the Lord.
Amen.
You are going to die. Message, make the valley full of dishes. And then she went to say, God is my healer. God is, she testified of healing.
Mm-hmm.
When God said she's going to die.
Amen.
Then the prophet says, it happened that the angel heard it.
Amen.
And let me tell you something that you didn't know.
Yeah.
It happened that the angel heard your amen.
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 Hallelujah.
And God says, go be seated in such a place. Do you know you're choosing your city spiritual? When you're just saying, okay, all right. It's in the program of God. God says you'll be seated in a certain place. Tell him. The angel heard it.
Amen.
Wonderful.
The prophet
Amen.
Was running away from the storm.
Amen.
In Colorado.
Colorado.
In the voice of God says, go back. Commit the storm. The prophet doubted the voice. Said, maybe it's the wind. Maybe it's something else.
Amen.
And then God, that voice gave it CV. He says, I'm the Lord who created this
place.
Go and meet your problem.
Right.
And he says, I say to this dog, go to your place. Stop.
Mira.
And the sun shine normally.
Amen.
For 4 days.
Yes.
No more than I say that. This little of hail, hail, which was about to blow me down, just stepped. And in a moment or two, the sun was shining.
Amen.
Do you know why those miracles
happened?
It was for a reason.
Amen.
The reason of the miracle was expressed when God says, why don't you walk with me?
Amen.
God is even used to walk with him. And that's why when Peter caught so many fish just in one short space of time,
Amen.
It was the highest peak of his business.
Amen.
When a businessman is prospering, he thinks of opening another branch. But when that miracle happened, Peter forsook that business.
It's
not a messina. You know, when the supernatural happens, you notice you are a sinner.
Yes.
God is not just there to say, receive this, receive that. He is doing those things
Amen.
So that you can walk closer to him.
Amen.
So Peter then falls at the height of his business.
He
says, Lord, let me follow you. That's what must happen today.
Hallelujah.
Let's take my feet so that I can cross.
Amen.
I believe things can change. Because the resistance is broken. Whatever was resisting you is broken. Princes of your family, bloodline curses and spirits are broken. Let me tell you, your testimony is coming. Your testimony is coming. Something is fixing to happen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, your testimony is coming. The angel of the Lord is here. But sister said, Mr. Devil, you are finished. Are you sick and tired of your situation? Are you desiring to receive the Holy Spirit now? Are you tired of your sins? Are you desiring the touch of the Holy Spirit? We are going to have war today. There's going to be war here. Satan must flee in the name of Jesus Christ. Chains must be broken in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is here for you, sister. He has heard the afflictions of his people and he has come down to deliver. You've been praying about something for so long. You've been applying the token for so long. You've been desiring a breakthrough for so long. You've been fasting about it for so long. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the hour. Don't miss it. Mr. Anderson missed it, but today no one is going to miss it. We put every situation under our feet today. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Spirit will say you will never be married. You shall be married. In Jesus' name. Nothing can hold you. When God has spoken, he will make a way for you. He is a way maker. He is a promise keeper. Your sickness is vanishing now. Jesus Christ is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. I want to bind what is binding you. Captivity must be captivated. You must bind the mamba. You are given power, my brother. answer you. God will bless you. God will protect you. God will fight for you. God will deliver you. Deliverance is here now. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Yes, I'm not going to preach deliverance to the captives. You are not sleeping at night under bondage. And today things are changing. The business was in the shallow waters. Things are not coming. You are failing to pay your tithes. You are failing to support the pastor in ministry. Things are changing today. This is the day. And you are the person. The anointing is here to break the yoke. You young boys, you are addicted to pornographic sites. You are addicted to dirty habits. That thing must end today. There must be an end. It started somewhere. It must end here. Burdens are lifted at Calvary. Jesus breaks every fetter. When Jesus is an appointment with his people, there is nothing that can stop it. The princes of Nyanga, we are breaking them. Territorial devils. We are ready for war now. I want you to be angry with the devil. Because Satan, you are finished. By the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the name of Jesus Christ. My breakthrough is happening. Nothing can hold you. Why did the bed there? At the bed there. God's hand is moving. Just reach out and say, Lord, I confess my sins. I've been too long in this mountain. I've been stepping for too long. I'm coming back now. I'm repenting. I'm making right. I'm confessing my sins. I'll meet the pastor about it. But now I want my release. Now I want my answer. Now I want my victory. It's a victory day today. I feel like create a bit of space. I may not be able to wait for the end of this COVID thing, but I want to pray for someone. I want to lay hands on someone. We are commissioned and empowered that these signs shall follow them that believe. Someone has been in prison for too long. Someone has been back, just distance yourself. Just make it through. Even up to you waiting wherever you are and being faith, then you will be coming so that we don't count. I'm seeing God delivering his people. House of heaven, keep way. Things are going to happen in this temple. I'm speaking it because I'm feeling it now. Yes. Yes, sister. Your time has come. As the Holy Spirit is moving, as the power of God is moving, nothing is too hard for God. Look at your situation and say goodbye to it. Look at your condition and say it's over. I want you to speak it in faith. I want you to speak it in faith. Can God feed a person?
Thank you, Lord.
Stubborn spirit. And I'm breaking them. In the name of Jesus. Be free right now. In the name of Jesus. Be free. In the name of Jesus. Let the yoke break. Stubborn spirit of Jesus. Right now, this very minute, our heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
peace to give me a great decision. It's difficult to remain that small, brother. They keep on playing itself. Let your healing play itself. Let your situation disappear. Right. Just be praying where you are. I'll move as the Spirit leads me. Maybe let's move that bench this one, so that I have more space. Just look at your situation. Forget about all others. God is calling you.
Hallelujah.
of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, tingana kuramba tichimba hama dzangu. Dzimbotse kusunungurwa. Dzimbotse victory. Hallelujah. Anyway, when you are watching our travel and so on, amen. Lord, we really appreciate our precious pastor. Thank you very much, Pastor. I don't know what it means, but I think it means
Takunda.
No wonder why. Pane kukunda pakati pedu. Hallelujah. Masita anywhere. Amen. I'm sure Mbala Tabernacle has left a mark in your heart.
Amen.
You'll never forget us.
Yes.
Amen. You'll never forget this tabernacle again. In this northeastern part of Zimbabwe.
Yes.
Amen. We are full of peasant people here. They don't have much, but they love the Lord so much. That much I know. Struggling to build a church here. Amen. We want Embala Tabernacle to be erected. We are sick and tired of this temporal structure. We want something more permanent. For we are looking for a city whose builder and maker is God. A permanent city. We love things which are permanent. Amen. Amen. All right. And so I'm sure all of you can say, Pastor, I'm waving my hand saying, come back again. Come back again to Nyanga. Are you saying the same? Come back again. Now, because he loves us all in Nyanga, next time he says, Brother Simango, I'm coming, I'll try to invite the other side. Amen. Because we believe the same things. In Lima division, I don't believe in it. I'm telling you the truth. It hurts me. Amen. I'll try to invite the other side so that we have a combined meeting with our precious pastor. Amen. I think these are people who are of the type with the ability to combine us. No, sister, I'm not secret ministry. It would be good, isn't it? Amen. All right. Anyway, let's come to the end of the service. Yeah. May I ask Pastor Abogo to come and close in a word of prayer. Amen. Brother Ezekiel.
Tinokutendai nekupodza kwamatipa. Tinokutendai nekupindura minamato yakange tichinamata mazuva akawanda. Tinokutendai namufundisi wenyu wamashandisa. Tinokumbira muvaropafadze vachidzokera vafambe zvakanaka. Ishe wangu nesu tiri kusara kuno vekunyanga vasari munyasha dzenyu. Ishe vari kufamba munyasha dzenyu zvakare. Tinorayira mweya yese ingada kuvhiringidza utano nemufaro wevana venyu kuti ishaye nzvimbo ishaye mukana zita renyu rirambe richisimudzirwa imi murambe muchipiwa mbiri tikwanise kutaura matestimony after this service nokutendai nomuzita rakakosha ratene Jesu Kristu amen.
Thank you.